Hello, Malty Mad Malt Worlds, and thank you to Curtis Fox for that malt mention. I'm Ralphie, this is Ralphie Review 662, and I am about to pour one of the loveliest bourbons I have tasted in quite a long time. Aged 10 years, it's called Eagle Rare. It's Kentucky straight bourbon whiskey, and importantly, it's been bottled at 45% volume alcohol. In other words, there are clear signals from the producer that they are meaning to keep their finger on the quality control button with this one. Sure, they could have bottled it at 40%, but the reason they haven't is because they know that there are appreciative customers all around the world who are looking for a premium, top drawer, American Kentucky straight bourbon moment. And with this bottle, aged 10 years, we have found one. It's very good. Thanks to you malt mates who recommended I look out for this. Hey, I listen to what you say. I know a good punt when I hear it, when I read it in the comments section. Thank you, malt mates. Distilled, aged and bottled by Buffalo Trace Distillery, Frankfort, Kentucky, USA. Roly stroly, no shaky shaky, you know the drill. The nose of a good fine single malt whiskey. You see, it doesn't matter where a grain whiskey is made. Quality is quality wherever you go in the world. And when the producers actually invest in quality, quality is what you get. Just like this. Fabulous. There is a richness of cereal. It is not tasting of genetically engineered corn, that kind of corn note that you get from young bourbons. This smells of quality ingredients. It comes through on the nose immediately. It is substantial. It is rich on the nose, and the caliber of maturation really immediately jumps out at you. It really is outstanding and understated, even better. This is a whiskey that you don't think you're going to get to know it in 5 minutes. This is a one that you linger with for several hours on a quiet, tranquil, pleasant evening, and no matter what company you keep, this is probably the best company you've got. I know that sounded a little bit cliched and shorthand, but work with me, malt mates, work with me. At a time when there is criticism about downsizing the presentation and caliber of bourbons, in the interests of a faster buck, this really stands out as a bit of a shining star. If I was in the US, I would probably buy a case of this to put aside for fear that the producers suddenly realised, hang about, this is too good for the punters. And that's in the nose alone. Superb nose. Taste. Tasting it neat. It hardly needs water. Beautiful, rich, toffeed corn note. Some delightful rye tanginess in there. The development, even as it stands, is quite, relatively complex. And the finish, it's actually got quite a sizable crisp tannic tea-rich, English breakfast tea-rich finish. I'm not adding much water, I'm just adding a drop. I really want to emphasise that it's with experience that you know just how much water do you want to add, and it would be very easy to drown this. It's just there's a certain fragility about this spirit. I would even, in a warmer part of the US, if that's where you are, pop an ice cube in. If you're down Alabama way or in Florida, but if you're up the road in Alaska, skip the ice, seriously. A little bit of plain water. There is a beautiful little mustiness coming through from the casks. Soft brown sugar, a little touch of muscovado, a distant note of treacle, almost of Jamaican rum in the background. There is a citrus note developing in the development. Slight orange conserve, some rosehip jam, almost as something you would find in Drambuie Scotch liqueur whiskey. There's that certain tangy cola note, red currant, some red fruits, some cranberry, some soft apricot on the nose coming through now with adding water. When you taste it, those 10 years have been very active, proactive maturation, and the softening of the original mash bill spirit has been wonderfully successful without diminishing the substance of flavour that has originally been created from the mixed grain recipe. It's delightful stuff. And thank you, maltmates, for suggesting I review this. I am reviewing it. Glad I bought a bottle. I better be quick and buy another before they all disappear now. It's just the way it goes. It really gives, the nose in particular, really gives Pappy Van Winkle a big run for its money. Top drawer stuff. Honey notes coming in now. The palate is softening. The rival is a little mellower. It's almost got some corn honey. There's a sort of cereal fruity honey note in the arrival. The development starts to take on more of a red fruit tanginess and a slight sour, beautiful wood sour note. And vanilla oil. The finish has got more of the vanilla oil, these delightful, soft but crisp tannins. From tea, from oak, from rye grain by the taste of it. And this is a joy. 90 out of 100. This is a bourbon mark for Eagle Rare, 10-year-old, straight Kentucky bourbon. Bottled at a higher strength. And that higher strength is really what is making this spirit. If I was the producer, single barrel versions of this, single cask versions, bottled at cask strength, would be an absolute reputation maker. But I'm not the decision maker over there. I'm just a humble, pesky anorak commentator who, even after all this time, experiences the profound joy of tasting a brand new spirit that I've never encountered before, and I immediately relate completely to the intrinsic quality of what it is. And I hope If you buy a bottle and you try this bottle and you pour a glass and you have it on your own and share it with friends, whatever you're going to do with this, I hope that you enjoy it as much as I have. But I would be quick if I were you, because possibly, quite possibly, the prices of this are going to start creeping up. Just sharing, just pre-warning you, it's the way it goes. I'm Ralphie. Tatty bye for now. Pop back again where I'll be reviewing a single malt Scotch whisky. See ya.